Coming up on Lumination News, there's a new member to our Lipscomb community, and it's been a long time coming. This building will be a home to popular majors on campus that will bring many students in each year.
Also, you may have noticed Bison Square was filled with booths and tables for Food Day 2012. Nutrition majors want to help promote a healthy lifestyle for their fellow students, and we'll tell you all about it. Your Lumination News starts now.
At Lipscomb University in Nashville, Tennessee. From the Department of Communication and Journalism. Recorded live from the Mulliken Studios in Ezel. A program produced for students by students. This is Lumination News.
Welcome to Lumination News. My name is Madeline Smith.
And I'm Nick Glendy. Lipscomb's brand new Nursing and Health Sciences Center has been officially opened and dedicated to the Lipscomb community. President Randy Lowry and Dean Roger Davis invited students and faculty alike to celebrate this special occasion.
Lipscomb University dedicated the Nursing and Health Sciences Center by Dr. Lowry cutting the purple ribbon, another Lipscomb achievement.
We have a lot of hands-on opportunity in the new building. We get to learn a lot more techniques with the new building, and I think it really represents us as a class, and I'm really excited to see what doors it will open for us for the future.
Yeah, I mean, for sure, I think Belmont will have to watch out.
And I present this building to you students and to those that will come after you. I charge you to be diligent in learning, to challenge your professors, to share with you the breadth and depth of their knowledge and experiences, and to daily reflect the image of Jesus Christ.
This has been Ariel Jones for Lumination News.
The dedication took place on the east lawn of the center, and following the ceremony and reception, tours were given to anyone wanting to get a guided look inside.
In a country where the rate of obesity is on the rise, some organizations are taking matters into their own hands. Food Day is a national celebration that promotes healthy and sustainable nourishment. Erica Alberto has the story.
There is no doubt that the biggest war this country is fighting is the war on obesity. Nearly two-thirds of adults are overweight and things don't seem to be getting better. However, Food Day is a day that is battling the growing bulge and promoting healthy, sustainable food. Lipscomb students and vendors came together to celebrate the special day.
Today we're celebrating National Food Day, which is a nationwide celebration of local, sustainable, and affordable food. And I got involved with this at the beginning of the semester when I participated in a Real Food Challenge training in Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
We sell Owsley Out Salsa here in Nashville, Tennessee. We make it from local grown produce around Davidson County. I think it's important to support our local farmers, and that's what we use as local products, vegetables and stuff from our local farmers.
My name is Adam Curtis. I'm with Good Food for Good People, and we act as a local food hub with about 85 farmers and food artisans here in Middle Tennessee. It's really important to support local food because it helps build a green economy where the money stays within your local area. And you just get healthier, better quality food.
And I'm with the Well Coffee House, and we are very much just a local missional coffee house, and we feel very strongly about supporting local, and we try to buy local, and we use local, and it supports our community and also gives back to our friends and family around the area. We are a nonprofit coffee house, so actually everything above our operating expenses go to the missional field of both here in Nashville and all the way to India, Africa, Honduras, Haiti, Jamaica, all different parts of the world.
This was Erica Alberto for Lumination News.
There you have it. All that food they had is really starting to make me hungry. This is the second year that the event has been hosted by Lipscomb's nutrition students.
Now that we're past the halfway point of the semester, it means it's time for those important advising appointments again. Most advisors have available office hours posted on their doors for students to sign up. To be prepared for your advising appointment, make sure you've taken a look at your grad map and have made a trial schedule to review with your advisor. Appointments are going on now and will continue through November 2nd, so make sure you sign up early so that there's plenty of available times. Registration for spring 2013 semester classes begins on November 5th.
The final Pizza and Politics Debate Watch was October 22nd, and as usual, filled Chamberlain Theater with excited students and staff.
Free pizza wasn't the only thing drawing students to Chamberlain Theater Monday night. Some were required to attend or came for extra credit. Others were hoping to find some guidance on where to place their vote. Here's what two students said about why they watched the debates.
Well, it's my first year of voting, and I want to just get a good idea of who's going to be taking charge of our nation and what their plans are, and hopefully they stick to it. So again, it's my first year voting and free pizza, so that's not a problem at all.
The reason I watched the debate is I feel like as an American, even though if you know who you're voting for, you need to be well informed, you need to be able to have a clear decision, and just be able to weigh all sides of all the issues so you can make the best decision possible.
The last debate watch party followed a similar format to the three events before it. At all of the events, most students polled said they would vote for Romney, and Monday night was no different. This is Emily Snell for Lumination News.
If you're still not sure who to vote for, go online and research where the candidates stand on the issues that matter most to you. Don't forget to exercise your rights by voting November 6th.
Fall break seems to have always come around just when we need it most. Last weekend, Lipscomb students traveled near and far from Nashville to celebrate their day off.
Fall break, it was cool this year. We went to North Carolina, saw my oldest daughter and my grandson, who's 2 years old. That was the important part. Stayed at a place called Mountain Air and enjoyed wonderful fall weather. Just a great moment of family time. That's what we did.
For fall break, I went back home for a day, and then my family took a trip out to my, my grandma actually owns a llama farm out in Colorado, and so we got to spend some time there with the llamas and feeding them and just helping her around the farm.
My sister just started her freshman year at Taylor University, so I went to watch one of her games in Columbus, Ohio, and met up with my whole family, my grandparents, cousins, aunts and uncles, and stayed there for the weekend and had an awesome time.
First, I went home to Jackson, Tennessee, and I did early voting, and then I went to Knoxville with my family to see Alabama play Tennessee. Roll Tide.
Over fall break, I went home to Cincinnati, Ohio, and my family wasn't there, so it was kind of a boring weekend. However, I got to go see the Bengals play the Steelers, which I want all of Lumination and everyone who's watching to know that nobody likes the Steelers and absolutely nobody likes the Cardinals.
Balls, a 6.5-foot trophy, and chefs with flying spaghetti. Last year's dodgeball game was certainly a sight to see. After the break, we'll take a look at the event and let you know when and where this year's game will be.
Food Day wasn't the only initiative held on this campus for promoting healthy living. The Fresh documentary brought students together to learn more about the food they eat and the healthy alternatives that might not know about. All this and more after the break.
He's a little bit of you, he's a little bit of me. He's the trash on the roadside of Tennessee. He's the garbage that we find. He's a dream we left behind. Oh, there ain't no lower class than Tennessee trash. A throwaway bottle or a pop top can may not seem much to a traveling man, but a little bit of litter goes a long, long way. Growing and a growing, getting bigger every day. Tennessee trash messing up the highways. Tennessee trash junking up the byways. There ain't no lower class than Tennessee trash. No, there ain't no lower class than Tennessee trash.
A trash-free Tennessee. Sounds good to me. A public service by this station and the Tennessee Department of Transportation.
We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We're going to beat them and bust them. Beat them.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
How much time?
A little bit. R-O-W. D-Y.
Take time to be a dad today.
All those boys are much too much. Those boys.
Dodgeball, one of the biggest events on campus, is returning to campus November 2nd at 7 p.m. Last year's event pumped adrenaline into all of the participants as well as the students who packed out the fanning courtyard to watch their friends compete. Last year's winners, the chefs, were presented with a 6.5-foot tall trophy and well-deserved bragging rights. This year's teams will duke it out once again in the Fanning Courtyard, dressed up as all sorts of different themes and costumes with choreographed team introductions. Anyone can be on a team, so if you want to play, contact Garner Good for more information. This isn't the last big event for students this semester. To see a list of all the student activities taking place on campus this fall, visit lipscomb.com/campuslife, and don't forget about Dodgeball on November 2nd.
The Lipscomb College of Arts and Sciences recently presented the second film in the Human Docs film series, The Revisionaries, in Shamblin Theater. The event was free and open to the public.
The Revisionaries is the story of Don McElroy, a dentist, Sunday school teacher, vowed young earth creationist, and recent chair of the Texas State Board of Education. During his time on the board, McElroy oversaw the adoption of new science and history curriculum standards that drew national attention. Dr. Ted Parks, one of the curators of the Human Docs film, told me why the topic of the film is important for all of us to understand.
I think the issue raised in the film, some of the issues raised in the film were important on several counts. The theme of the film that I see is really not primarily whether evolution is a valid theory or if a person of faith can embrace evolution. The topic of the film, I feel, is how do you approach education? Is education about indoctrination? Is education about keeping ideas from students? Is education about fearing that students will learn the wrong thing? Or is education about presenting students with viable options?
A discussion panel of community experts followed the film. They answered questions from the audience and expressed their thoughts about the film and education.
It's about rethinking what the role of the educator is. And is the role of the educator to disseminate information to students, or is the role of the educator to provide opportunities to students to explore?
The Revisionaries was directed by Scott Thurman and has an average rating of 6.2 on IMDb.com and 6.6 on RottenTomatoes.com. This has been Mona Sam for Illumination News.
The Revisionaries won the Special Jury Award at the Tribeca Film Festival and has been featured in the Nashville Film Festival. For showtimes, visit Human Docs on the Lipscomb Events page.
Lipscomb students and faculty have the opportunity to learn about something concerning all of us, the food system. They did this by watching the documentary Fresh. Fresh celebrates the farmers, thinkers, and business people across America who are reinventing our food system.
The documentary Fresh was shown as part of the Food Day on campus on October 24th.
I am a caretaker of creation. What I'm supposed to do is leave it in better shape for the next generation than I found it.
Maha Mortada, a graduate student from Lipscomb University, and Emily Brunson, a current student, came up with the initiative to show this documentary on campus.
So I really, really hope that we can get something started on campus and raise awareness and make students more proactive about solving the problems in our food system.
After the showing of the documentary Fresh, the students had the opportunity to find out more through a panel of experts.
You know, I'm really resistant to answer or address your first question. First question said, is this a Christian issue? Is food a Christian issue? And I'm really, really hesitant to answer that, but I'm going to go ahead and do it anyway. I don't think it's a Christian issue unless Christians eat. I think it's an issue for anybody who eats. And so for those Christians who eat, it is an issue for them, since we all eat.
It's really uplifting, and it shows people that are making real change in their communities. And I think it's really inspirational and kind of got me excited about the change that I'd like to see here at Lipscomb.
It was produced and directed by Sophia Jones, and it was released in 2009. Since then, it has reached many audiences throughout the world. This was Jael Teme for Illumination News.
Forging healthier, sustainable alternatives, they offer a practical vision for a future of our food and our planet. To know more about what you can do, visit www.freshthemovie.com and learn 10 easy ways to help improve our food system.
You may notice something a little different when you try and log into your My Lipscomb account. The Information Technology Department has revamped the My Lipscomb site to create a completely new environment. The biggest feature on the new site is a launchpad which will allow you to plan your academic path, develop your portfolio, and connect with the community. If you have any problems with the new site, you can contact the help desk by emailing them at mylipscombsupport@mylipscomb.edu. The site is live at mycampus.lipscomb.edu.
While many may know where they stand on this topic, there are still plenty who remain undecided. No, we're not talking politics. We're talking about what to dress up for Halloween. This week, the Nashville Spotlight is on Performance Studios along Thompson Lane. Here's some inspiration from Jeremy Keck, Jael Temme, and Bryn Watkins if you are undecided on the issue.
Welcome to Nashville Spotlight. In this edition, we have a spooktacular angle that we're going to be taking. Since it is that time of year, Halloween's sneaking up on us ever so creepily. So let's go in here to Performance Studios and see what costumes that we can put on to prepare for that big Halloween extravaganza coming up. Let's take a look.
Performance Studios has so many hats available to complete your costume look. But do I want to be a pizza man or a fire chief? That's the question. Which one?
Oh my gosh, there are so many. I don't know which one to choose for my costume.
Need that Halloween mask to scare all those other Halloweeners out there? Performance Studios has every mask you could possibly think of to add that spooky spark to your Halloween this season.
I'm lucky to be out of there alive. It is scary in there. Woo!
As you can see by the shoe selection at Performance Studios, there is a shoe to complete your perfect Halloween outfit. Let me see what they have.
Oh, this is the perfect one.
No, I want this one.
No, I want this one.
No, I want it.
Give me the shoe.
I said, give me the shoe.
There are so many scary items to make your Halloween extra spooky.
I'm just kidding. We're just playing around here.
Here at Performance Studios in the costume rental section, you will be able to find your dream Halloween costume. I mean, look at me. I'm the Queen of Sheba right now. Am I not?
I'm glad that Performance Studios has super costumes for super men like me.
I feel like a princess in my new costume.
I'm feeling a little Cruella this Halloween season. What do you guys think? Good?
I'm off to fight crime.
I hope you enjoyed this week's spectacular National Spotlight on Lumination News with myself, Bryn Watkins, Jael Temme, and Jeremy Keck. Join us again next week to see what we have for you for National Spotlight.
Can you believe we get to vote for the president in less than 2 weeks? Let's go to Bryn for this week's politics.
The third and final debate between Governor Mitt Romney and President Barack Obama ended on a high-energy kick. Both candidates showed so much enthusiasm while discussing foreign policy, which was the cornerstone of the debate. There were both high points and low points for each candidate as they discussed their resolutions and ideas for dealing with affairs around the world. Both Governor Mitt Romney and President Barack Obama have clearly been doing their homework in foreign policy, as well as intimidation strategies. Stare-downs and squinty glances were in abundance as the presidential candidates gave their all in the last debate before Election Day on November 6th. With Election Day right around the corner, I strongly encourage you to look over both candidates' promises and strategies for the future with a critical eye, research your choices, and most importantly, go out and vote if you are 18 or older. The decision of Election 2012 is an important election of our generation and will greatly affect the world in the next 4 years as well as you directly. Make your voice heard and go out and vote. I'm Bryn Watkins with your political update for Lumination News. Tropical Storm Sandy has officially been classified as a Category 1 hurricane. Stick around because after the break, Nicolette Carney will update you on the hurricane and what you can expect this weekend here in Nashville.
Thank you. you do to my sign?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Thanks, love.
Hi, this is Nicolette Carney with your weather update. As you can tell, we do have a new system. It's Hurricane Sandy, which is now a Category 2 hurricane, moving north at 105 miles an hour with the pressure at 963 and moving again north at 20 miles an hour. And now we go to our watches and warnings for this hurricane. We have hurricane watches and warnings in effect for the Bahamas and the east coast of Florida and in our southern Bahama areas. Like I said, we have a Category 2 hurricane moving up north for 105 miles an hour. And then for our impacted areas, Florida, around the east coast of Florida, you should be on alert that the remnants of the hurricane could have bands that could move into your direction. However, if you are living up north and are east, please be on the lookout. This hurricane is coming towards your direction. If you are told to be evacuated, please do so. What does this mean for our weather maps around and for the rest of the United States? We have a huge high pressure system that is coming towards the eastern direction. The high pressure system that we have now, which is a result for our beautiful weather and our above normal temperatures, will be pushed out this weekend, and we do have a chance of rain. Now we're moving on into our southeastern region. Excuse me, not our southeastern region, but our temperatures. With the high pressure front that is coming through, as you can tell, we do have a drastic temperature change. The temperatures ahead of the front are right now in our 70s and our 80s, and the temperatures behind the front are reading in our 30s and our 40s, and even some places, as you can tell, we are reading at 22 degrees. Now for our southeastern region, our high pressure, once again, that is responsible for our beautiful weather, will be pushed out this weekend. And then coming in, we have a new low pressure that is going to be pushing through into the southeastern region. And now for our temperatures. We have 90 degrees right now in Brownsville, 83 in Shreveport, Louisiana. And we have a high temperature of 80 degrees in Raleigh-Durham and 84 in Columbia. And now for our regional temperatures across Tennessee. We have right now Memphis at 81 degrees, Paducah at 80 degrees, and then we get to our eastern regions where we have 77 in Chattanooga, 78 in Knoxville, and 81 in the Tri-City area. And now for our local current temperatures right now here in Nashville, we have partly two mostly cloudy skies with the temperature reading of 80 degrees, wind south of 14 miles an hour with the humidity at 42% and our pressure at 29.97. Now for our 7-day forecast. We have, again today, our beautiful high of 82 with partly the mostly cloudy skies. Then on to Friday, we do have a 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms with a high of 67 degrees. Saturday, our temperatures go down again with a 30% chance of rain at 57. However, Sunday, the conditions clear up and we'll have a beautiful sunny sky, but rather low temperatures at 57 degrees. Monday at 55 with sunny skies, and then Tuesday and Wednesday, we will have mostly cloudy conditions at 54 and 57 degrees. That was your weather for this week. Now we're moving on to the desk with Crystal Davis with our entertainment.
Where'd Justin Timberlake go, you might be asking? He said bye, bye, bye to all of us single girls everywhere. Find out why after the break.
It's time. It's time. Time for us to group up and go to war. If you want something you've never had, you have to do something that you've never done before. As we stand here with the realization that a change needs to occur, we have to develop a spirit, a passion, a flame, a desire that cannot easily be deterred. What was once old tradition is set to me new. This is no longer about me anymore. It's about you. I stand with my brothers to the right of me, my sisters to the left of me. Together we not only look to leave memories, but lasting legacies. Welcome to Bison Country. This isn't just school, it's a lifestyle.
Band together now. Stand up. Experience passion. Learn fearfulness. Become unified. Become proud.
This is the stampede.
Now is the time to be united. So join me. Let your voice be heard. I've never seen a champion without fans or supporters. So stop complaining. Stop being scared. Become bolder. Restore order.
Tomorrow's not promised. So if history is to be made,
then it starts with us. And it must
start
today.
Thank you.
It's finally happened. Justin Timberlake is only allowed to bring sexy back to one lucky lady from now on, Mrs. Timberlake. And who is the lucky lady, you might ask? She's none other than Jessica Biel. The two were married at a resort in Italy with 100 of their closest family and friends. The bride walked down the aisle in a one-of-a-kind pink strapless haute couture gown with a princess-like silhouette. Guests got a surprise when the groom serenaded his bride with a song he wrote for her on their special day. Guests included former NSYNC bandmate Chris Kirkpatrick, Jimmy Fallon, Andy Samberg, Timbaland, and Biel's Seventh Heaven co-star Beverly Mitchell. People magazine was on hand to cover the wedding exclusively. On the flip side of harmonious matrimony, the memorable Joe and Tina Simpson, parents to Jessica and Ashley Simpson, have filed for divorce. You might remember that you were introduced to them on Jessica's hit show Newlyweds, which she appeared on with her ex-husband Nick Lachey. People magazine confirmed from the couple's representative that the split is amicable and there's no third party involved. The two were married for 35 years. All Access Nashville with Katie Couric recently aired. This is a 2020 special that puts country singer Leanne Rimes in the spotlight. Rimes has recently been in the headlines for her love life scandal that filled the tabloids for months. Rimes and her now husband, Eddie Cibriani, started an affair while filming a Lifetime movie in Canada. The two were married at the time, but were not to each other. The divorce from their now divorced from their previous spouses, happily married to each other, Rimes said she was suffering from severe anxiety and stress, stemming from the tabloid gossip. The singer said that it's only human to be hurt by stories, you can't ignore everything. After much speculation and an eating disorder, due to Rimes' thinning body, she checked into a month-long treatment facility to take care of herself. I'm Crystal Davis, and that's been your entertainment update for Lumination News. Stay tuned for our latest Lipscomb sports, the Titans, and some activities that have been labeled under the top unusual 100 sports. Stay close and don't go away.
Hello, sir. We're checking today to make sure everyone in the car is buckled up. In Tennessee, everyone must use a safety belt. It's the law. Break the law, you'll get a ticket.
We're also out to help protect everyone from impaired drivers by checking for drivers who've been drinking.
Oh, sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Come on, I've only had like two or three beers.
Sir, if I determine that you've been drinking and driving, you will be arrested and you will go to jail.
If you don't buckle up or if you drink and drive, make no mistake, you will get caught.
Volleyball middle blocker Jill Dawson had a career high of 22 kills during the game against Jacksonville, which Lipscomb won, by the way. Dobson ranks third at all-time Lipscomb for a player with at least 12 kills in a match. Congrats, girl. The Bisons had an unfortunate turn of events when the men's soccer team went into overtime with USC upstate. A last-minute header lost the game 1-0. The team's final three regular season games will all be on the road, starting with the match at Jacksonville. Good luck, boys. Now on to basketball. The Lady Bisons have been hitting it hard in their fall practices. Head coach Greg Brown has seen improvements, both offensively and defensively. The ladies' first game will be November 1st at 5 p.m., where they will host Freed Hartman in Allen Arena. Did you see the fourth quarter against the Buffalo Bills when the score was 28-34? The Titans have been stepping up their game lately. Quarterback Matt Hasselbeck connected with wide receiver Nate Washington on a 15-yard pass and with an extra point. The Titans left the Buffaloes with a 35-34 win. See what happens when you believe in your team? And lastly, I leave you with two sports that I don't even know how they made it into the sports category. Birdman Rally is a sport where a man is in a highly decorated flying machine and tries to jump off a bridge or pier to see who can go the farthest. Quite brilliant, huh? This last one is called Worm Charming. Yes. Worm charming. This wonderful sport has competitors finding creative ways to get worms to surface by really any means except divvying them up. Bleach has been banned from the method. Well, whatever tickles your fancy. This has been Ariel Jones with your sports. Stay active, stay healthy. Now let's go back to Nick and Madeline at the desk.
And now it's time for your tweets of the week. Some students live and work at the library during the school year. Sometimes their schedule can be a little disrupted when newcomers appear in the study area. Chris Saunders tweets, "Goodbye, basketball team. I enjoyed your rap music, video watching, and loud talking. You will be missed. Hashtag library problems."
Students weren't the only ones who were excited about getting a day off from school. Bible professor Philip Camp tweeted, "Sleeping in and chocolate chip pancakes, a good way to start fall break."
And don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Lumination TV. I'm Nick Glendy.
And my name is Madeline Smith. Thanks for tuning in.